Okay, yesterday we have discussed about capacitor. Yeah, capacitor is electronic device to store or to keep the charge inside. Okay. So we have discussed yesterday that the capacitance of a capacitor depends on the geometry of the capacitor. For example, we have a parallel plate. Yeah. The capacitance of the plate depends on the area of the plate and the distance between two plates. Okay. The second, if you consider a cylindrical capacitor, yeah. So you see that if you consider a cylindrical capacitor, so the internal radius is R1, yeah. And the outer radius is R2, okay, capital R2. So we will get that the potential difference between these two pole, yeah, it should be delta V equal capital Q over 2 pi epsilon L, which is L is the length of the capacitor, this one. So this is the length of the capacitor. This is L, yeah, capital L. Okay, log capital R2 over capital R1, okay? So the capacitance of a cylindrical capacitor, it should be 2 pi epsilon 0 L over ln capital R2 over R1. Okay, you can see this in the textbook also. And this is, and the last example, okay? For a spherical capacitor, the internal radius is capital R1, okay, and the outer radius is R2, yeah, for example. The potential difference between inside this spherical capacitor is delta V capital Q over 4 pi epsilon 0. 1 over R1, capital R1 minus 1 over capital R2, okay? So we will get that the capacitance of a spherical capacitor, it should be depends on its internal radius and the outer radius, okay? Oh yes, I have a remark, some notes, yeah. The outer cylinder is made for metal, yeah. This is metal or conducting material, and this one also the internal, okay, and also this outer, this is also metal, and this is also metal, okay. Okay, so we have three examples that shows that the capacitance of the capacitor depend on the geometry of the capacitor, okay, for parallel plate capacitor, cylindrical capacitor, and a spherical capacitor. Okay. Is there any question in this case? Any question? No. Okay, let us continue. So as we discuss just now, yeah. For example, if we consider a parallel plate capacitor, okay, with the distance d and the area A, capital A, so the capacitance of this capacitor is epsilon zero, capital A over d, okay, where epsilon zero here, because inside the capacitor we feel only we feel nothing, okay, only a vacuum. Okay, so that's why this permittivity, it's vacuum permittivity, okay, epsilon zero. What happen if I insert a material called insulator, yeah, or isolator in bahasa? Where is it? Okay, what happened if I insert the capacitor, okay, inside this the insulator, the material called, let's say, insulator inside the capacitor, the parallel capacitor, okay? So inside capacitor, this pole, this plate, yeah, which is which are a free charge, yeah, plus sigma and minus sigma, this pole plus and minus, yeah, there will be electric field, yeah, inside this. So this also there is also electric field, okay, inside this capacitor. This E, okay. So this electric field inside the capacitor will induce so-called the induced charge, yeah, additional charge, yeah. For simplicity, we could take, for example, this induced charge as a dipole. So dipole means that this electric field, this green one, will induce charge, yeah, because this insulator consists of atoms, yeah, atoms and molecules, yeah. For example, if we turn on this electric field, these atoms or molecules, they become dipole, okay, they become dipole. So dipole means this is the simplest case, yeah, for insulator. So this dipole charges will generate we so-called electric field, but in particular we name it as a polarization factor. So the electric field caused by the dipole charges, we call it polarization factor. Okay. And in general, inside the material, for example, as an insulator, the total electric field, yeah, it should replace this electric field A should be replaced by this D. We call it this displacement of electric field, displacement, yeah, of electric field inside the material. Okay, so this is the formula. So in the vacuum, the polarization factor will be zero or finish, okay, because there is no material inside the vacuum. But in insulator, there will be a polarization factor, okay? That's why we have to modify this electric field by this displacement factor, okay? So in this lecture, In this lecture, just a moment, yeah. Just a moment. Just wait. Where is it? Where is it? Okay. Okay, this one. Okay. So, in this lecture, in particular, we consider a special case, yeah. We call it this P is proportional to the electric field. Okay, this is a special case of property. This material called a linear material. Okay, because the polarization factor is proportional to the electric field. Okay, so because this is proportional, there is a constant, yeah, we call it xi e. This we call it electric susceptibility constants. Yeah, that really depends on the material. Yeah, which is yeah. I mean, each material is different. For example, for each insulator. Okay, and this d here, this displacement factor, can be simplified into epsilon zero times one plus xi e. Times E, okay? So this quantity, 1 plus psi E, we call it the electric constant, okay? Okay. Is there any question in this case or any comments? Any comments?
So can I ask?
Yes, yes, please.
This special property, what do we use it for? I'm sorry.
This special property. You yes, mean the application yes, like, or the useful?
Yeah,
or
yeah. We use it to calculate.
Yeah, if one. Yeah.
Polarizing if factor.
Yeah, you could also compute the polarization factor. Okay. So, if you have a problem, for example, an exercise, yeah. For example, this in the exercise, yeah. We mentioned that this is a linear property or linear material. It means that the polarization factor is proportional to the electric field. Okay, so we should give the information about its electric susceptibility constant. We should inform that in the exercise or in the problem, for example. Yeah. But in general, this is not a constant, okay? It's depend also on the temperature, for example. It also could depend on the electric field itself, yeah? It could be anything. But this special property, this xi e, we call it electric susceptibility constant, is a constant. It's really a constant, just for simplicity. So if we do that, yeah, this D, this capital D equals to epsilon E, where epsilon E is K times epsilon zero. Okay. So, so this is for vacuum, yeah. For if there is an insulator, yeah, this E, this electric field, equals to sigma over epsilon, okay, where epsilon is this one, K times epsilon zero. Okay, if you compute, yeah, if you compute the capacitance here, yeah, you see that this is a the the above formula, yeah, is for vacuum, okay. But in below is epsilon, yeah, epsilon. We just replace it epsilon zero by epsilon, okay. This epsilon is the material permittivity, yeah, linear material permittivity, yeah, which is k times epsilon zero, which is k is the electric constant, okay. So it means that the capacitance, yeah, change, yeah, the property change if we inserted, if we insert inside the capacitor is of inside the capacitor a material called so such as insulator, yeah. So because you see that this because kappa here, sorry, not kappa, k is greater or equal to one, okay, this should be epsilon should be greater or equal epsilon zero. So it means that just we call it, this is epsilon, this epsilon zero, okay. This is for vacuum, so this is for insulator, for capacitor inside insulator, okay. So it means, so it implies that the capacitor, the capacitance of the capacitors become greater, okay, than the vacuum. Okay. Okay, that's what is that? That's the influence, yeah, of the insulator inside the capacitor. That the insulator increase the capacitance of the capacitor to store the charges. Okay, is there any question in this case? So this is the advantage of this insulator. Why, for example, we use insulator to increase the capacitance of the insulator? Okay, any question? Any question? Okay, so this is for yeah, for this material, yeah, the last material today. Okay, this is another example, additional maybe, yeah, before we discuss module one. So what about if we replace the insulator by a conductor? Okay, by a conductor, the field inside the conductor will be zero. Okay, so the charge inside conductor should also zero. Okay. So if we plug in or insert the conductor inside the capacitor, then we cannot define the capacitor itself, the capacitance of the capacitor. If we plug in inside the capacitor a conductor, okay, because there is no electric field, no charges inside the conductor, okay? So we cannot define this capacitance of the capacitor for if we plug in inside the conductor, okay? So what about if, for example, half of this capacitance, we insert the conductor, half of them. So as mentioned above, the electric field inside the conductor should be zero, okay? But we have the electric field here for the vacuum, okay? So we still have, we could still use the definition of the capacitance here, C equals Q, capital Q over delta V, yeah, for this case, if we insert only part of it, not all of it, okay? Okay, that's I think this is the last material for capacitor for this week. Okay, is there any question? Question? Okay, jadi akan saya review sekali lagi. Ya, jadi intinya ketika kita memasukkan isolator ke dalam kapasitor yang tadinya vakum ya, E di sini. Nah, E di sini medan listrik di dalam kapasitor itu menyebabkan mengenerate atau membangkitkan namanya muatan induksi. Nah, muatan yang induksi itu yang paling sederhana itu adalah dipol ya. Jadi molekul atau atom-atom pembentuk isolator ini dia terpolarisasi lah ya, terpolarisasi. Jadi plus minus seperti itu. Jadi artinya kita ada medan tambahan. Nah, medan tambahan ini itu kita sebutnya namanya vektor polarisasi P gitu ya. Nah, makanya medan listrik total dalam sebuah isolator itu, dalam sebuah kapasitor itu nanti diganti displacement. Yang rumusnya seperti ini. Oke. Nah, untuk kuliah kita, untuk sederhananya, ya kita mengambil hal yang khusus, yaitu vektor polarisasi ini itu sebanding dengan E. Oke. Jadi kalau namanya sebanding itu berarti dia depannya ada konstanta. Nah, konstantanya ini kita nyebutnya psi. E itu adalah konstanta susceptibilitas elektrik lah bahasa Indonesianya. Jadi nanti kalau kita gabungkan jadi satu tambah ke xi e itu kita sebut namanya konstanta dielektrik gitu. Seperti itu. Jadi nanti pada akhirnya ketika kita masukkan isolator ya kapasitansinya tinggal kita ganti aja jadi yang epsilon 0 tadi yang vakum ini kita ganti epsilon di mana epsilon itu adalah ini. K kali epsilon 0. Ya, artinya apa? Karena K itu lebih besar atau sama dengan 1, maka ketika kita masukkan isolator di dalam kapasitor itu sifatnya dia jadi menaikkan kapasitansi di sebuah kapasitor. Gitu. Jadi salah satu keuntungannya gitu, kenapa kita memakai isolator. Kalau kita pakai konduktor, itu malah jadi rugi sifatnya. Jadi malah kita tidak bisa mendefinisikan definisi kapasitor kalau untuk konduktor. Gitu ya. Jadi harusnya isolator. Oke, mungkin itu aja dari saya untuk yang materi ini. Kita akan bahas tentang modul ya, modul 1. Saya akan menunjukkan solusi. Solusi ini nanti akan dibagikan di EduNext ya oleh koordinator. Jadi makanya nanti kalau Anda minta saya belum bisa membagikan karena nanti yang membagikan itu adalah hak prerogatifnya koordinator. Nanti akan serentak dibagikan di EduNext gitu di kelas paralel ada. Sampai sini dulu ada pertanyaan nggak sebelum saya lanjutkan? Ada pertanyaan? Oke, tidak ada. Kita lanjutkan. Oke, this is the question ya, part A question. If you have a natural object ya, jadi which is natural ya, in electric an object which is natural electrically, okay. Concerning the mass of the object is true, okay? So the mass increase if the charge is negative, decrease is if it is positive, yeah? Okay? Ada yang kurang jelas nggak di sini? Atau butuh penjelasan lagi? Cukup jelas. Any question, comments? Oke, ini yang paling mudah seperti ini. Anda tahu atom kan ya? Atom. Atom itu kan ada inti yang bermuatan positif, ya. Misalkan ini sembarang lah ya, sembarang atom gitu ya, terus di sini ada elektron yang mengelilinginya. Katakanlah elektron keluar gitu ya. Ini awalnya netral. Kemudian elektron ini saya ambil. Jadi pastinya dia akan bermuatan seperti misalkan H itu kan netral ya. Ketika dia ambil elektron jadi apa? Jadi H plus kan. Gitu. Plus elektron gitu. Gitu ya. Nah, jadi kalau dia itu positif, ya jadi massanya akan berkurang. Ketika dia itu negatif, massanya akan bertambah. Oke, ini contohnya HCl aja. HCl itu kan, ini kimia ya, kimia. Itu kan ada H plus dengan Cl min ya. Gitu. Cl itu dia netral. Dia kan golongan keberapa? 7A ya. Jadi kalau dia itu capture elektron gitu ya, the mass will increase, oke? Okay? Jadi massanya akan bertambah. Jadi walaupun massanya bertambah, walaupun sangat kecil ya, even it is very small ya, but it is the increasing of its mass of Cl, chloride atoms, oke? Okay? Becomes an ion, negative ion. Oke, okay, is there any question? Oke, okay, is it clear ya? Oke. Okay. Is there any particular question? If you have any problem for this module, module 1. Is there any question? No. Okay. So if you number two, if you consider a proton and electron, okay. They place in the x-axis, okay? Proton at minus d and electron is at x equals to plus d, okay? And they release simultaneously, okay? So which particle reaches the origin first, okay? So they have on proton and also on electron on it, yeah. It acts the force, yeah. The force of the same magnitude, okay. But they have different sign, okay. The different opposite direction, okay. So because the mass of the proton is much much larger than electron, okay. So the larger mass, so it should be the acceleration becomes smaller, okay? Okay, so it means that the electron will reach the origin first in this case. Okay, because the acceleration of the electrons is much, much bigger yeah, than the proton. Okay, it means also if we apply, for humans, for example, yeah, if you have more white, yeah, or becomes whiter, yeah, so you will have difficulty to move. Okay, that's the Newton's law of motion. Yeah. That's nature. Okay. Okay, number three. Okay, is there any particular question in this case for you? Is there any difficulties when you work with your homework? Hello. Is there any particular question? Hello. No. Hello. Are you sleeping or?
No, sir. No particular question.
Yes, no particular question. Okay. We can discuss directly number six, yeah. Number six. Okay, number six, we have three charges, yeah. I think we have three charges. Q1, Q2, and minus Q, okay. So this is the picture, okay. So we have this rectangular have length 2D and the height is D, okay. So you just see this picture, okay. The net of electric field upper the right corner. Oh, okay. So if the point, okay, here, if the net of the electric field is zero, okay, the E resultant is zero, find the magnitude of Q1 and Q2 in terms of Q, okay? Okay, is there any difficulties? Okay, let's see. Okay, so for the magnitude of EQ, yeah, the minus Q, okay, is KQ over the magnitude, yeah, the magnitude of Q, yeah, over R squared. So the distance between minus Q to this point, the right corner point, is D square root 5, okay? So we have this 5D squared. Okay. And E1, yeah, equals to Q, K times the magnitude of Q1 over 4D squared, okay? E2 equals this one, K, magnitude, the magnitude of Q2 and D squared. So, okay. So we get that this theta here is around 26.57 degree. Yeah. Okay. So the tangent theta is a half. Okay, one over two. One half. Okay. So we get that this Okay. So, because the electric field here is vanishes, okay, this one, yeah, it vanishes, okay. So it means that each component, yeah, in the x-axis should be zero, and also the vertical component or y-axis also zero, okay. So in this case, we will get that the magnitude of the capital, the magnitude of Q1 is 0.716 Q, and Q2 in this one. Okay, is there any question? So Q1 and Q2, yeah, is a positive charge, yeah? Yeah. Q1 and Q2 is a positive charge. Okay, minus charge only in this, on the left below, yeah, minus Q. Is there any question for this problem? If not, let us proceed to number 7. Okay, an electron is released from the rest, yeah, from at rest, yeah, at the negative plate. Okay, how fast is the electron moving just before reach the positive plate? Okay, So it is known that the density of the plate, each plate is sigma is 1.8 times 10 to the minus 7 coulomb per meter squared, and the distance, the plate separation is 1.5 times 10 to minus 2 meter. Okay. So in this case, because the initial condition of the electron is at rest, so V0y is zero. Okay, the is 0 meter per second. Okay, so the acceleration Ey equals to F over M, where F equals to E times capital E, yeah, which is the electric field over M, where M is the mass of the electron. Okay, so because this is a parallel plate capacitor, okay, we have this E equals to sigma over epsilon zero. Okay, and we get this Vy squared, yeah, is 2 times E sigma over M epsilon zero times Y. So if you plug in the E is equal 1.6 10 to the minus 19 coulomb, sigma also 1.8 times 10 to the minus 7, and the distance, yeah, the distance is Y, Y is the distance, okay, is 1.5 10 to the minus 2. So this is over divided by the mass of the electron, okay, here. And then this vacuum permittivity, this one. So you can use your calculator to compute that it should be 10 to the 7 meter per second. Is there any question in this case for this number 7? No? Okay, let us proceed. What about number 8? Yeah. So we have a circular surface with the radius zero. Okay, and it is exposed to an external uniform electric field of the magnitude 1.44 times 10 to the 4 Newton per coulomb. The magnitude of the electric flux through the surface maybe it's not circular surface, yeah, like a spherical surface, maybe it should be. Yeah, the English is good. It's not really good. Okay, this should be not circular. Circular is one dimensional. Spherical surface is two dimensional. So it should be 10 dimensional. Sorry, not 10 dimensional. It should be two dimensional, I'm sorry. Sorry. So the so this is the electric flux through the surface, and then what is the angle which is less than 90 degrees between the direction of electric field and the normal surface? Oh, okay, okay, okay. So you just plug in. This is a circular, not spherical. Okay, okay, this is a circular. No, sorry, not spherical. Sorry, spherical surface. Yeah, okay. Maybe not spherical. Yeah, disk. Yeah, disk surface. Okay, disk, not spherical. No, sorry, not spherical, not circular surface, but a disk. Yeah. Circular is like a ring. Okay, disk. You know disk. Yeah. Okay. It's solid. It's solid disk. Okay, so you just plug in to the formula, this one. Okay, with the area of the disk is PR squared, okay? So you will get that the angle between the flux, the electric field, yeah, between the electric field and the normal of factor of the surface should be around 58 degrees. Yeah, it should be, okay, circular. Yeah, it's not really clear the questions, I think. It should be, they should give the picture, I think. Okay, number nine. Is there any question? Number eight. It's not really clear. I mean, yeah, should be. They should give the picture. I think circular surface. Okay. Number nine. Charges. Lies at the center of uncharged thin spherical, okay, conducting cell, so made it from the conductor. So what is the electric field A as a function of R? Okay, we have discussed it. R is less than the radius of the cell B inside the cell. Okay, and beyond the shell. How does the shell affect the field? Do Q alone, and how does the charge Q affect the shell? So this is the shell, okay? So this is the shell. Okay, if we consider, for example, A is the radius of inner surface, and the B is the radius of outer surface, okay, B. Okay. So let me see, I should draw, okay. So we have this one, okay. This is A, and this is B, okay. Okay, for R less than A, okay, because Q enclosed inside, because we have electric field at the center, which is Q here, capital Q, okay. So QS should be plus Q, okay. So we will get this electric field inside the capacitor, inside the sphere, okay, should be KQ, capital Q over R squared. And between, so in the cell, yeah, which is between A and B, because it is a conductor, it should be zero, okay. For greater than B, yeah, it should be KQ, capital Q over R squared, okay. Okay, so D, how does the shell affect the field? Do Q alone of does? Okay. I should write maybe in green. Okay, so because this is plus here, so this plus Q here will induce inside the surface inside of the sphere, okay, this should be minus Q, okay, minus, okay, and inside the outer surface of the conductor should be plus, okay. So the total charge inside the sphere is still plus capital Q. Okay, is there any question in this case? Any question? No? Okay. If not, we proceed to the last question. So this is non-conducting. Yeah, non-conducting mean like insulator. Yeah, insulator. We omit the induced charge. Yeah, we only consider for free charges. Okay, so a solid non-conducting sphere has a positive charge, which is distributed uniformly. Yeah, throughout its volume. Okay, the density of charge, is a constant. Okay, because it uniformly distributed. Use the Gauss law to show that electric field at a point within the sphere at the radius r is a magnitude. Okay, so it means that we consider only, I think, inside, inside the sphere. Okay, the solid sphere. Okay, so if you use the Gauss law, okay, this one. I think we have discussed it, I think, in the lecture, I think. So the electric field inside the sphere should be proportional to the R, okay? This R, where capital R is the radius of the sphere with this R, this little R, is a point inside. The radius of the point inside the sphere. Okay, this is the sphere. Okay, and this is, for example, any point here. This is the center, and this is R here. This is R. Okay. And this is the radius of the sphere, this capital R. Okay. Is there any question in this case? Any question? Okay, akan saya ulangi lagi ya. Dari yang pertanyaan pertama ya. Pertanyaan pertama, jadi ini udah jelas ya, jadi massa itu berubah karena bertambah atau berkurangnya muatan. Jadi ini biasanya kita ambil pada level atomik gitu ya. Elektronnya itu berpindah ya, sehingga dia itu menjadi positif atau dia menangkap elektron sehingga menjadi negatif. Kemudian ini untuk yang nomor dua, misalkan kalau proton dengan elektron, ya jarak antara keduanya terhadap titik asal itu sama, satu di minus d, satu di plus d. Mana yang lebih dulu? Gitu. Nah, ini kalau kita lihat di sini, gaya yang bekerja pada proton dengan elektron itu sama besarnya. Oke, sama besarnya. Ya. Nah, cuma nanti yang membedakan itu nanti percepatannya. Kalau percepatannya lebih besar, itu berarti dia sampai lebih dulu. Ya. Kalau percepatannya kecil, sampai belakangan. Intinya gitu. Nah, yang menariknya di Newton itu adalah karena gaya itu sama dengan M kali A, ya, kalau kita lihat di sini, massa proton itu jauh lebih besar dibandingkan dengan elektron. Sehingga nanti percepatannya itu pasti lebih besar elektron dibanding dengan proton. Jadi, massa makin besar, percepatan makin kecil, gitu ya, sehingga dia akan makin lambat. Nah, ini juga berlaku untuk kita manusia ya. Kecenderungan kalau kita itu berat, itu biasanya akan sulit untuk bergerak. Ya, orang yang badannya gemuk juga mungkin termasuk saya, itu susah untuk lari, gitu. Makanya perlu yang kurus, gitu. Seperti itulah kurang lebih. Jadi hukum Newton tentang gerak ini kalau saya lihat itu alami lagi. Kalau yang ini perlu dibahas nggak? Muatan titik negatif berada dalam benda listrik yang bercerita muatan positif. Manakah pernyataan yang benar? Jawabannya itu adalah seperti ini. Jadi D ya. Medan itu menjauhi muatan positif, tetapi gayanya karena ini negatif, dia berlawanan dengan arah medan. Oke? Seperti itu. Ya, rasanya ini. Nah, langsung ke nomor 6 ya. Kita bahas. Nah, ini nomor 6 di sini. Ini ada tiga muatan ya. Plus Q1 dengan plus Q2 sama min Q ya di gambar di sini. Sedangkan titik ininya di titik di pojok kanan atas ini dia istilahnya tidak ada muatan. Dan di sini dibilang medan listrik di sini nol, oke, di titik ini. Jadi itu bagaimana hubungan antara Q1 dan Q2 dinyatakan dengan Q gitu. Jadi kalau Anda lihat di sini, besar akibat muatan negatif itu gayanya ini. Sedangkan akibat E1 besarnya itu seperti ini, dengan E2 seperti ini. Kalau dari gambar kita lihat, tangan teta itu adalah setengah. Ya. Tangan tetanya setengah. Jadi kalau Anda bisa lihat tangan tetanya setengah, Anda bisa hitung cos dengan sininya berapa. Oke. Jadi karena medan di titik ini nol gitu ya, maka setiap komponen vertikal atau horizontalnya itu dia harus nol ya, sehingga nanti dari komponen horizontal kita dapatkan Q1 itu besarnya itu adalah 0,716 Q yang itu juga tentunya positif, sedangkan yang Q2 itu adalah 0,0895 Q yang juga positif. Ya, ada pertanyaan? Tadi siapa yang tunjuk tangan? Halo? Ada pertanyaan nggak?
Sorry, sir. Tadi ke raise hand tidak sengaja, sir.
Oke. Kita lanjutkan lagi. Nomor 7. Nah, ini nomor 7 sebenarnya gambarannya mudahnya. Anda bayangkan plat sejajar, kapasitor plat sejajar. Muatan elektron itu bergerak dari negatif ke positif, kan? Pastinya. Oke. Jadi di sini ada muatan rapat muatannya yang 1,8 kali 10^-7 kolom per meter persegi dengan jarak antar plat. Ini udah mudah di sini. Ya, ada elektron itu muatannya E ya. Jadi kebetulan kalau AY di sini karena dia itu awalnya itu diam ya. Karena dia dilepaskan dari diam, maka V0-nya akan diam. Sehingga nanti kecepatan ketika sampai pada kutub positif ya, karena jaraknya adalah 1,5 cm ya. Jadi didapat Anda langsung masukkan ke rumus aja seperti ini. Ya di mana pakai rumus ini ya, VY kuadrat sama dengan 2AY kali Y. Di mana AY itu adalah EM E kecil E besar dibagi M kali Y. Kita tinggal di akar di square root. Kemudian yang ke-8 ya. Ini permukaan ya, jadi ya permukaan lingkaran ya tadi ya, oke lah mungkin seperti ini Mas. Jadi dia harus ditambahkan gambar ini harusnya. Jadi ini ada permukaan lingkaran gini. Permukaan lingkaran lah ya gitu. Kemudian ya ada medan listrik gitu ya. Ke sana gitu gitu. Yang menembus, ya harus ada gambar, yang menembus permukaan lingkarannya. Gitu. Oke, jadi Anda tinggal, kalau di sini Anda tinggal masukkan ke flux aja. Ya, rumusnya seperti ini. Jadi fluxnya kan dikasih tahu ya. Radiusnya dikasih tahu gitu ya. EA-nya juga dikasih tahu, ya udah Anda tinggal didapatkan. Ya, V ini adalah sekitar 58 derajat dari rumus ini. Oke. Okay. Kemudian yang nomor 9, ini muatan Q terletak di pusat konduktor bola tipis. Ya, tadi kan kita udah bahas, ya, ini jadi di kuliah rasanya juga udah dibahas. Ya. Jadi kalau untuk di dalam yang R lebih kecil dari A, ya, E-nya itu adalah ini, K, Q besar dibagi R kuadrat. Ini sama halnya dengan yang di luar, yang C. Sedangkan yang di dalam kulit konduktor, itu karena dalam konduktor itu kan muatannya adalah nol, apa nol ya, jadi E-nya juga nol. Ya, jadi untuk B ini nol, untuk yang C itu nol. Maaf, untuk yang B itu nol, E-nya. Kalau yang C, rumusnya sama dengan A, tapi syarat batasnya beda. Ini ada R lebih kecil dari A, kalau yang A, kalau yang C itu R-nya lebih besar dari B, jari-jari terluar. Nah, jadi pengaruh muatan di pusat itu menyebabkan adanya induksi di kulit dalam dengan kulit luar. Kalau di kulit dalam itu adalah minus Q, sedangkan di kulit luar itu adalah plus Q. Tadi udah saya gambarkan ya, jadi tidak perlu digambar lagi. Kemudian kalau untuk nomor 10, jadi sebuah bola isolator ya, isolator padat gitu ya, bola pejal gitu ya, dia isolator itu berjari-jari R besar dan dia bermuatan positif tersebar merata. Jadi ya, sebab merata di seluruh volume gitu ya, dan rapat muatannya adalah konstan karena dia tersebar merata adalah Q kecil dibagi volume dari bolanya gitu ya. Jadi Anda dapatkan apa namanya medan listrik di untuk yang di dalam bola gitu ya, yang berjarak R di dalam bola. Jadi tunjukkan gitu ya. Jadi bahwa E-nya itu sebanding dengan R. Jadi ini tinggal Anda pakai hukum Gauss ya. Hukum Gauss yang di sini, ya Q enclosed-nya itu adalah fraksi muatan. Fraksi muatan ini adalah volume Gauss surface. Yang ini adalah volume dari bolanya. Jadi bisa didapatkan bahwa Q enclosed di sini itu adalah Q kecil kali R kecil pangkat 3 dibagi dengan R besar pangkat 3. Sehingga nanti didapatkan E-nya itu adalah ini. Oke, mungkin itu aja dari saya. Kalau tidak ada pertanyaan, berarti kita sudahi. Sebentar, saya isi dulu. Kecuali kalau ada pertanyaan. Silahkan, ada pertanyaan nggak? Pertanyaan. Sekarang tanggal berapa ya? Tanggal 11 ya. Takut salah ini saya. Oke, tanggal 11. Oke, absensinya Anda mandiri aja ya. Saya ini kan sampai jam 11. Oke, ada pertanyaan nggak? Pertanyaan. Saya udah apa namanya berbusa-busa nih. Udah berapa menit? Ada pertanyaan nggak?